Welcome everyone to yet another interesting session of Apex for students. Today is day five, and we're going to be talking about how we can, what are the different declarative tools that can be used on, or are available on the Salesforce platform to automate business processes, right? I have another today. The session is going to be conducted by Atul, who needs no introduction. And Atul, over to you.
Thank you, Jigar. So welcome to the fifth day of Apex Hours. So today's topic is automating business processes, part one. So we'll conduct this business process automation in two parts. Today I'm going to cover part one, and tomorrow there will be a part two. I'm Atul Rajguru. I'm working as a technical architect. I have my Twitter handle and YouTube. A LinkedIn details are on your screen, just in case if you want to follow me. Agenda. So today we have a very interesting topic, and that is about the business process automation. So Salesforce is known for its business process automation, right? So Salesforce have really powerful platform that can cater to various business need and make sure that whatever manual stuff or manual activities that employees or resources of organizations are doing, those can be automated using some of the very easy and powerful tools in Salesforce. Okay, so we will talk about what are the business processes and then how to automate them. What are different options available to us for doing this? So in today's session, we'll majorly focus on three different items. Okay, we'll focus on workflows, we'll focus on process builder, and the last part is email template. Okay. So some of the housekeeping items, please keep your mic on mute. Keep adding questions to the Zoom window. We will try and consolidate them, and Jigar will, sort of help us on asking those questions and addressing them at the end of the session. And you can ask, as this is, this series is intended for the students, so you can ask almost any questions related to Salesforce, and we will be more than happy to help you. Don't hesitate, how to ask this question, or whether it is very basic or very advanced. You can feel free to reach out. We will try our level best to help you out and solve the queries. And just in case if we ran out of time, we will log, we'll always have those logs of questions, and then we will try to post the question answers on the Apex Hour channel or the Apex Hour site, right? So without further ado, let's start with the business processes, right? When we say business process, what does it mean? Okay, so business process is nothing but a series of steps performed by a group of stakeholders or users, right, to achieve a certain goal, right? So if you want to do certain activities in the organization, or if we certainly do certain activities in the organization, right, we can call them that whole process as a business process. Like for example, on when you take admission in college, right? So there is an admission process, right? You give application based on your ranks, marks, and your location. You get admission to a various college, and there are various entrance tests and stuff like that, right? So those are what, those are processes. So similarly, we have business processes in the organization. So when we think in a bigger terms, so there is one flow that I have take as an example, and you can see that this process is employee claim process, right? So for example, if an employee is traveling for business and he do certain expenses, right? So he may travel to visit client, he may take out client for a dinner, or you know, he may do some expenses during traveling, he may need a cab and other related activities, right? So all those expenses employee cannot bear from his pocket. So he will obviously need to claim that from the organization. Now, to claim that all those expenses, what he'll need to do, he'll need to provide all that information to the organization that I have done all these expenditures, and then the organization need to verify. So the supervisor, what employee will do, employee will fill out the expense form, right, and submit the expense form. Supervisor will receive the expense form. It will validate all those expenditure are appropriate and within the given limit, right? If those are not, then employee will, he will reject certain expenditure. So for example, as per the organization policy, you're not supposed to submit a laundry bill, but then you have submitted, then manager may or supervisor may reject that particular invoice. But so based on the criteria, like various criteria, you can either approve those certain expenditure and reject certain expenditure. Once those are approved and authorized, right, those goes to your administration or the accounts department, right? They receive all the details, they log the expenses for accounting purpose, right? And then they make the payment, and then employee get the notification. This is the one example of the business process, okay? So to do this, right, to achieve all this, what we have, like suppose if you want to implement something very similar to this or a small version of it, how we can do this, right? So we will provide you certain pointers and certain steps, and then you will be able to follow those steps in your dev work and try these steps yourself, okay? So we will first go to the first automation tool, that is workflow. So workflow is divided into three important pieces, okay? So, or I would say two important pieces, okay? So evaluation criteria. So criteria tells that whether the workflow should process this particular record or just stop processing. So that is the evaluation criteria, when the record is newly created, right? So that time, do we want to evaluate the workflow? When the record is edited, that time you want to evaluate the workflow. Or the third is like you want to evaluate when it is created or when it is every time it is edited, but not the subsequently. So for example, once the expenditure are approved, employee cannot submit same expenditure multiple times, right? So that is the evaluation criteria. The rule is like once we say that, okay, I want to create a workflow rule, which is which should apply whenever we create a opportunity record. So we will go in DevOrg and try this out actually, so that you will get a better understanding. Okay.
Thank you, Atul. Let me hand over. So guys, let me show you how to get the workflow. So to get a workflow, first of all, you need to click on the setup and click on the setup option here. And when the setup option will be open, you in the quick find, you just need to search the workflow option. So once you found the workflow option, you just need to click on the workflow rules. When it's open, like it will give you detail about what is workflow, what all action you can perform over here. So you can see the workflow. We can perform like four action in the workflow: task, email alert, field update, and outbound messages. So these all options are available here, and this is basically used for like to achieve any business process. And for this demo purpose, I'm just trying to create one workflow on the opportunity closed date. In that, we just need to send an email alert to the opportunity owner, your opportunity is closed, and we need to create one task and need to assign that particular task to the opportunity owner for particular activities, and we can also do the field update. So we will see like how we can do that. So if you want to create a workflow rule, just click on the new rule here. And after clicking on this, it will be asked you to select the object. So from the drop down, you can select the opportunity object. And then click on the next. And once you're done, then you need to provide the rule name here. So here I'm getting like giving the name as a close opportunity alert. And here there is a three thing, like one is the rule name and another is the rule criteria. So this is very important, guys. Like there are three criteria coming here. So one is the created. So if you want to like your workflow should be executed when you will create the record, then you can select this option. And there is another option like created and every time edited. So in this particular option, it will be triggered every time you will create the record or every time you will edit the record. It doesn't mean like last time your criteria is already met, but if you'll try to execute this one again, then it will be fired again. So it's mean like if our criteria should be opportunity closed date. So very first time when you change the opportunity to from any other status to the close one, then it will be fired. But next time, if you'll try to edit the same opportunity and will try to edit any other field, not the status field, then also it will be fired. So if you want, like trigger should event should be fired only one time. Whenever first time it meet the criteria or subsequently meet the criteria, you can select this option. It's mean like if you try to change the opportunity close date from the prospect or any other status to closed, then it will be fired. But if the opportunity status is already closed and you're trying to edit the same opportunity and trying to update any other field, it will be not fire. But just in case if you change from closed one to any other status and will again change to the closed one, then it will be triggered again. So it will be only fire when it will be subsequently meet the anti criteria. Here one more important thing, like if you select this one, then we cannot create the time dependent workflow. So I will be explaining about detail in the like which all types of workflow we have. So we have two work types of workflow. One is immediate action, another one is time dependent action. So immediate action is something whenever the condition will be happened, it will be executed immediately. But there might be possibility we need to do some activity based on a particular time. So suppose you want to send some email one day before the opportunity close date. In that kind of scenario, I can use the time dependent workflow. So I will give you a separate demo for that. For this, I'm going to select the subsequently criteria. So here you need to specify the criteria. Either you can use this particular condition from here, or you can also write the formula from here. So if you want to write a formula, you can use this one, or you can directly use the criteria are met. So our criteria is opportunity status should be closed one. So just select this one and select equal and select the option. So I want to execute this on the closed one and click on the save and next. So I already set up my criteria, okay, when it should execute. So my workflow will be executed whenever you will change the opportunity status to closed one. And now I told you there are two types of action we can add, either time dependent one from here or the immediate action. So for this demo, I am going to use the immediate action. So here we just need to do three activity here. We need to send an email alert, we need to create a task and field update. So I'm going to do the, first of all, I'm just going to create a task here. So click on the task and assign this particular task to particular user, like who need to do what. So for this, I'm just going to select this task to the Purushottam and saying that please follow with the client and give a unique name, and here you can decide, here you can define, okay, what should be the due date. I'm saying that whenever the trigger will be fired, the and plus 2 days should be the due date for this. And here I can write something, okay, comment so something, whatever you want to do, you can do it. You can specify the status. It's, you can say not started. You can set the priority, whatever the record you want to create. Based on that, you can set the priority and everything and click on the save. So this is the field. I just created a task location record. And similarly, if you want to do something, you want to create another action here. Like I want to trigger an email, and then you can also click on the new email alert. So from here, I'm just like want to give a description. What should be this? Like I'm saying close opportunity alert. I'm just giving this, and then you need to select the email alert templates. So right now I'm just going to use anything like existing email template, whatever I have for the demo. And later on, I will tell you how we can create a new email template as well. For if you just in the case you don't want to use the existing one and you want to create your own. So I will explain that later. So right now I'm just using the existing one. And here you can define, okay, to whom all I want to trigger an email. So I can say, okay, this should trigger to all of them. So I just selected this one. And if you want to say add any email ID explicitly, you can add the email ID here as well. So I'm just saying, I'm just passing my email ID here. So you can also send someone into additional email address. Here you can specify the trigger should be executed from which email address and all. You can do that and then click on the save. So now my email alert is ready. It will be triggered the email alert. And just in case if I want to update, like whenever the opportunity will be closed, I want to update some field on the account. So that what also I can do from here. So let me see what all field I have on account. So we will change something from here. So whenever the opportunity will be closed, I want to do some field update on account. So let me see what I want to do. So let me update the rating field here. So I want like whenever opportunity will be updated, then I want to update the account rating as a hot. So we can update the same opportunity or we can update the parent record as well as a part of the field update. So I'm going to use the field update here and we'll update the account record from this. So from here you can see only parent option is coming. So direct parent. So whatever is the master detail. So that's why account is coming here. So not all the child, it will not show the child record. It will show only the parent record with the master detail lookup. So from here you can see all the account field here. So I'm going to change the rating field. So you can select the rating field from here. And now which value you want to specify, you can specify, okay, I want whenever it opportunity will be closed, I want to update the account rating as a hot. And I'm going to save this one. So now my workflow is ready. So this workflow will be fired whenever the opportunity stage will be closed one. So it is going to create a task assigned to a particular user and going to send an email alert and will update the account record. So this here I updated the account record, but if you want, you can also update the opportunity record. So till now I'm good. So let's test this workflow. For that, make sure you need to click on the done. And after that, this should be activated. Now my workflow is ready and activated. So let's see how we will trigger this one. So I already have this account, or let me create new opportunity or find it out any existing opportunity. So I have this opportunity. Let me check the account rating as well. So make sure it should be something else apart from hot. Okay, this is plank over here and opportunity is here. So let me mark this opportunity as a close. So from status, I'm just selecting this as a close one. On the close one, now check like task is created or not and account is updated or not. So let me refresh this one. So you can see when task is created, that is assigned to Pushottam saying that please follow with the client. So whatever the field that we set up, okay, the status should be not started, and whatever the comment we added, everything is coming here. So base whatever we set up in the workflow, that is coming here. Now let me check the account. Account is updated or not. So here you can see account is also set up as a rating is set also updated as a hot, and you can also check your email is triggered or not. So let me check my email. So you can see one email is triggered and this is my email alert. So I got. So this is how you can use the workflow. So now let's see if we want to create the time dependent workflow, how we can do that. So again, follow the same step, click on the setup, search for the workflow, click on the workflow rule and create a workflow rule with some criteria. So now this time for the demo purpose, I want to create one task on a opportunity before 1 day opportunity close date. So for that, let's create one workflow rule. So click on the workflow rule. Click on the new, then select the object, which object you want to create the workflow rule. So here I'm going to select this opportunity. Now I want to select this subsequently meet criteria, because we cannot create the time dependent workflow on every time created and edited. So I'm going to select this one, and criteria should be date does not equal to null. So I'm just going to save this one. So my criteria is that it will be fired whenever the opportunity closes does not equal to null. And this time I want to select the add time dependent triggers. So here I want to trigger it 1 day before the opportunity close date. So in this drop down, only the date field will become. So I just want to select the close date. So it will be triggered 1 day before the opportunity close date. And then click on the save. And now here you can assign any, add any task over here or email alert, whatever you want to do the same action. Or if you already have the existing task, you can select that one, or let me create the new task and assign this task to Amit Singh this time. And priority should be this, and priority should be high, subject follow with the client. So whatever you want to do here, you can do it, and then click on the save. Okay, this one is already created. So let me give some different name. This is just for the demo purpose. I'm just giving some value, random values here, and then click on the done. Now click on the activate. now go back to any opportunity and edit any record. So let me edit this record here. So now let me check what is the close date for this. So let me update the close date. So you can see the close date is this. So let me update 15th of August and click on the save. So as per the time dependent workflow, this should be fired one day before. It's mean my date is like 15. So it should be trigger on 15. My date is 16. So it should trigger on 15. So how you can track? So simply go to the setup. And go here, search the workflow again. And under the workflow, we have the time-based workflows. So select this option. And from here, you can search all the record which all are in the queue. So here you can see this record is created today and schedule date is 15. So this task will be created on this particular date. Okay, so this will be created on this particular date. Now, the question is that if like I already set up this and this record is already in queue, and what about if somebody will come and change the date? So let me change the date and see like from the 15, if I will update this particular date from 15 to 13, then when it will be triggered. So question is that it will be still trigger on 15 or it will be update the criteria and it will be executed one day before the opportunity close date, that should be 12. So let's see that and click on the search and see. So automatically Salesforce will be change the date. Salesforce will be automatically recalculate the date. But what about it's a one day opportunity close date and if I will update close date as today. So what should be the triggering date? It should be in past. So this is one criteria you need to practice and post your comment like what is the result for that. And I will wait for your answer like what you got the expected result or when it's got triggered. So this is all about the workflow and the time-based workflow. So
let's talk about how to create the email template. If you want to create an email template, click on the setup. From here, you can go and click on the email template. And from the classic, select the classic email template over here. And from here, you just need to click on the new template. And there are four options to create the email template. One, you can use the text one. You can use the HTML with the classic letterhead, or you can use the custom one without letterhead. And also you can use the Visual Force for creating a new email templates. So for demo purpose, we will select the text and click on the next. And from here, whatever the value you want to select, you can give here. So first of all, you need to select the where you want to save this particular for email template. So you can select your personal email templates or unified public email template. So I'm just using this folder and make sure this checkbox should be checked. Otherwise, you will not able to use this one. And then provide the email template name, my custom close opportunity template. And then from here you can give it you can give the subject also, opportunity close notification. If you want to give some value here, you can also use the dynamic value with the help of the merge field. So from here you can select okay to whom you want to send an email. So suppose I want to send on opportunity, so you can select the field from there. So I just select opportunity field to whom you want to send this one. So you can select the whatever the field we have. Let me select the opportunity owner. I can select opportunity owner space, then opportunity owner last name, or you can use the opportunity owner full name. Like that, you can use the merge field. whatever the detail you want to give, you can give here, like name, close date, and opportunity link. So suppose this all value you want to send, and then you want to say system admin. So if you want to get some more value from here, you can select okay link. Detail link. So like that, you can use the merge field. Opportunity close date. And the name. Is the opportunity name. So you can use like this and click on the save. So here's the detail. If you want to verify, you can click on the test and verify. You can select on which particular contact you want to trigger, on which particular opportunity you want to trigger. You can select the record from here and it will be triggered in email. So let me select any opportunity from here, this one. And let me add my email so that we can see the email alert. So you can see it will be sent this particular email to me. So automatically it just converted like from the merge field to the actual values. And if you want to verify the email, you can verify email as well. So here is my email. Now, just what about if this is the text email, if I want to create the company letterhead, how we can do that? So to use the company letterhead, you can use the letterhead option. So click on the letterhead option. From here, you can create your own letterhead. But to create a letterhead, you need a logo, and that logo should be saved into the document object. So here, what you need to do, just go switch to the Lightning or switch to the Classic and upload the logo into the document folder. So go to here and click on this plus sign and search for the document object. And here, click on the new and upload your logo. Now you can see, you can use for external use, where you want to store, you can use it. Now click on the, select the file. Now click on the save option. Okay, I just uploaded my logo here. Now go back to the Lightning again and select the letterhead option. Click on the setup. Select the letterhead option. And now click on next. Provide the name here. So I'm just going to create one. Make sure this should be checked. And Apex R letterhead. Click on save. Now, so we have like it's divided into three part. One is the header, main body, and the footers. So in the header, I want to add a logo. Then click on the head logo. You can select the logo from here. So that is the same file is coming, which I just uploaded into document object. Select this one. So now it is coming like this. If you want to add something on footer, you can add. If you want to add something on the body, something like that, you can do it. But right now I'm just saving this like that. Then click on the save. Now, if you want to use the same letterhead in the email template, then you can get another email template. So your letterhead will be look like this. Now go back and use the email template. Now click on the new. This time select the HTML email template. Letterhead demo. Now from this you can select your letterhead, whatever you just created, and then select the layout. Then if you want to specify the subject, you can specify the subject. Click next. So now you can see it will become like this. And here also, like if you want to add any merge field, you can pass your merge field here. And just in case, like say same thing, hi, and select the opportunity owner name. So like that, whatever you want to add, you can add like this. So you can add more merge field if you want. And I'm just going to use this one, click on the next and save. So I just save this one. If you want to verify this one, you can verify. And in the same email template, now you can use the in the same workflow, you can use this email template as well. So go to the workflow. Click on continue. So we created this one, close opportunity alert. Here I will going to edit this one. I'm sorry. Click on edit. Now go to the close opportunity alert. Click on edit. And this time I will be change my custom template. We just created this one. I'm going to use this one. Click on save. And click make sure it should be activated. Go to a workflow rule again. And this is activated. Now whenever you will update your opportunity to close, now this email alert will be triggered. Now let me update any opportunity to closed. Now I just updated. So you can see task is created. It should also trigger one email. So let me check my email. So you can see one email is triggered with the letterhead. So like that, it will be work. There is another way to record the create the email template. So if you want to do, click on the app launcher and go to email go to letterhead first. You can create a letterhead from here as well, enhanced letterhead. So you can go here, you can create the enhanced letterhead from here as well. So click on new, and then you you can provide your letterhead name, like Apex R enhanced letterhead. You can give name here. If you want to select any logo, you just click on this. You can browse and upload an image directly from here. So I already have image, so I'm just going to use this one. If you want, you can click on upload and upload a file from there. I'm going to use this one. Click on this. If you want to set the value image size, you can use whatever you want to use. And After that, if you want to do some, you want to add some merge field here. So there is an option called insert merge field. You can use this one and you can use the merge field from here. So you can select, okay, this should be triggered from which particular object, something like that. You can select and use it. So I'm just going to add it. I'm going to add only the logo here. I'm going to click on the save. But similarly, you can also add the footer here, but I'm not going to use anything else. So just making it simple. Click on the save. Now your letterhead is done and ready to use. And now if you want to create the email template, you can also create the email template from here. Just click here and type the email template and click on this email template. Let's say contact email template, and here you can select the entity on which particular object you want to use. I'm saying I want to use an account contact, and you can specify it should be stored in public and private. Here you can add the subject name. So let's say welcome email to contact. From the enhanced letterhead, you can select the letterhead whatever we just created. So, and there, if you want to use any merge field, you can add the merge field here. So let's say hi and use the contact name. So let me select the contact name. So let's say full name, and you can select the name like this, and whatever the merge field you want to create, you can do. Thanks, system admin. You can use like this and click on the save. Now let's see how I can use this one. Now go to the contact. Select any contact. So let me select this contact and go to the activity option, and there's an email alert option. Email option is here. Click on this, and from here you can select your own email template from this option. Just click on this and create and update the template, and you can select your own email template, whatever I just created. So contact email template, I can use this one. So now you can see it is auto populated the logo and whatever the merge will I created. So once I will click on the send, it will be automatically update the name and everything, and all done. So click on the send and it use the updated email templates. So this is the use of enhanced email template and enhanced letterhead option. Let's talk about the process builder. In the process builder, we can do lots of activity which is not available in the workflow. So in the short, I can say process builder in the enhanced version of the process workflow. And in the like, take an example, if I want to post some something on the chatter, if I want to invoke an Apex class, I want to create some custom record, and I want to do invoke the flow, so that all things are not possible from the workflow. And one more thing, in the field update, in the workflow, we can update the parent. But what about from the parent, if I need to update all the child code? So that is something which is not available into the workflow. So let's see, if I need to, if whenever the account address is changed, I want to update the all the related contact address as well. So if you want to achieve this functionality, that is something which is not possible with the help of the workflow. And similarly, if I want, like whenever the address will be updated, I want to send a like a chatter post, that is also not available. So if I want to update address, I want to send a notification saying that address is updated on all the contacts. So if I want to do that, so that what we can achieve with the help of the process builder. So let's see how we can do that. So click on the setup, and then click on the setup here, and from there just type, just search the process builder. Now click on the process builder. Now click on the new. Now give the name here, let's say update child contacts. Now this is my requirement, and you can give the description over here. Now you need to specify when it should be a trigger. So you can say on a record change, or it can be executed from the platform event, or it can be invoked from the another process filter. So now this time I'm going to select the change record. Now click on the save, and if you see, it is more look like the flow chart. So you can say it started from here. If you can specify the object, okay, on which particular object you want to fire. So I want this should be executed from the account, and you can specify when the record is created, or when the record is created or edited. You can specify the option, whatever the process here, then click on the save. And after that, if you want to add multiple condition, you can add the multiple condition over here. And here, if the condition will be met, then after that, you can select the immediate action, which should be executed. So now my criteria is that whenever the account address is changed, then my process filter should execute. So here, I'm just going to provide the name, like, own account address change. So here you need to specify, okay, when it should trigger. So it should trigger when the condition will be met. There's no criteria, formula criteria, whatever you want, you can specify here. So I want whenever the country will be changed on account, then a country should be also updated on child contact. So I just want to update on a country only. I'm not going to do for all other field, but you, for your practice, you can select whatever the field you want. So I want whenever the billing country will be changed on account, then the same billing country should be updated on a contact as well. Select this one. This should. So here I can say select the is change. So is change mean whenever it will be changed, and I will say whenever it will be changed. So like that, if you want to select multiple condition, you can select. If you have a multiples condition, you can select the OR and operator, or you can also use the customized formula here. So right now I have only one condition, so I'm just clicking on the save. Now you can see my criteria is set when it need to execute. Now what all I need to do, I just want to update the contact record from here. So now you can see previously in the workflow there was only four options were available, but in the process builder we have a lots of option. You can invoke a Apex class, you can create a record, you can do the email alert, you can execute the flow, you can use the chatter, you can go execute another process builder and quick action, custom notification, submit for approval, and update records. So whatever you want to do, you can do from here. So this time I'm going to do the updated record. So I'm going to select this one. So here you can specify so here you just need to specify the name. Update child contact record, and from here you can specify you want to update the same record or you want to update the account related record. So from here I'm just going to select the selected record related to the account, and which record you want to update, I'm just going to contacts. So here I'm going to search all the child contacts. So here I'm going to select the contacts. So once I will select this one contact, so it will be fetch all the contact related to this account. Now click on choose. Now if you want to update, you want to add any criteria. Criteria means like if you have a multiple contact, you don't want to update all the contact, or a specific contact you can do, or you can if you want to update all, then no criteria need to require. So here I want to update all the contacts. So here what I want to do. So simply I just want to say which field I want to say update. So I'm going to update the contact mailing country. So from the mailing country, I want to update mailing country from the account field. So here I'm going to use the field reference, and from the field reference, I need to select the account field. So I'm going to select the mailing billing country. So I want this billing country should be populated on contact mailing country. So similarly, if you want to update more field here, you can do that. And now I'm going to click on the save button. Now it should execute an account whenever account address account country should be updated. It should populate the account country on the contact country field. Now if you want to add some more action, you can add the more action. So let's select one more action here. So I just want to use the chatter feed as well. So you can select the chatter feed, post to the chatter. I can provide okay. Posted notification, and now I can select any user. So I want for the users, and which user I can select a user, whatever the user I want. Apex our speakers, and you can say contact address is changed. So if you want to use any merge field, you can also use the merge field from here. So just in case I want to select any field from here, country, so I can say billing address. So I just updated this one, billing country, and click on the save. Now what I'm doing, so I'm just updating the all the child contact record, as well as I'm sending the chatter post here. So now all set. What I need to do, I just need to activate my process builder. Click on confirm. And once it is activated, so I just activated now, and now this is all done. So now what I need to do, let me go back to any contact and see the address of it. Now here, let me change the address for this. I just updated to NEM, so just want to see the changes, not this one. Now go back to the same account for this account, and now you can see for this particular contact address is India, and let me change the address for this particular account. Then the same address should be populated on the contact. So let me do the change here. So it is already United States. So let me change something here, United States, and click on the save. Now I just updated the address this. Now let me go back to the same contact and see the address is updated from India to United States or not. So you can see the address is updated from India to United States here, and I also created one chatter post. So if you want to verify the same thing, you can go to the chatter post. So go to the chatter post, chatter tab. So here is the chatter tab. Search for the chatter tab and see here. So now you can see contact address is changed, United States. So both action is update executed. So this is all about for today demo. And thank you everyone for joining us.